I carried water from the river to our fire. I put my five little ones to bed, smiling and squirming. In their eyes, the usual recognition, gratitude, peacefulness, and love. They asked me to tell them the stories of the stars, the beginning of life, until they fell fast asleep, dreaming their Lakota dreams. As I climbed up to bed, something flashed across my mind, like a shock from far away, an explosion. I tried to catch it, but it disappeared. That's when the dream began. A long, dark moment unfolded. As if I was traveling across hundreds of years. All things became afraid. All living things fought to survive. Trees became fearful of being chopped down. Rivers ran scared of being poisoned. Even the air ran for its own breath. It was the fear that had contaminated the world. I looked at my five children sleeping in their beds. What would they do if their water was ruined? How would they live?
Here. Everybody's unarmed here. Stand down. You're on core land. You're out of your jurisdiction in this water.
The dream went deeper. Underground. Under the earth. The fire under the earth. The oil that caused it spread everywhere, up through the water and into the scorched skies, rising oceans, collapsing cities, millions fleeing their homes, starvation, death, and ruin. In my dream, my friends and loved ones were sent to the last place on earth that still had clean air, clean water, unpolluted and uncontaminated. A great river ran through this center place, Minisosi. We needed to protect the water at all costs. Was this a vision of the future? The present? The past? I don't know. The battle for the future is laid out clearly before me. On one side, greed, fear, money, violence, hate, and oil. On the other, generosity, faith, freedom, peace, and water. The black snake has been prophesied for generations. Ehani. It was foretold that it would bring death, that it would be the youth that would rise up, and that behind them the mothers would rise. And behind them, our warriors would rise. We, the seventh generation, are given the task of defeating it. It is called the Dakota Access Pipeline. It is proposed to carry billions of gallons of crude oil from the Bakken Shale in North Dakota to Illinois. To do that, it has to run underneath the Missouri River, the Minnesota, the water source for 17 million Americans, and the only source of water for my home, the Standing Rock Nation. Pipelines like the Black Snake have burst in the past, permanently destroying watersheds like the Kalamazoo River and many others. In fact, there have been thousands of spills in the past 6 years. Thousands.
We run!
We run!
For our people!
For our people!
We run!
We run!
For water!
For water!
Water is life!
The Youth Council of our nation took it upon themselves to set about the task of waking the world to our dream. They ran from our reservation at the center of the continent all the way to the headquarters of the colonial system, Washington, D.C.
We run!
We run!
For our brothers!
For our brothers!
And our sisters!
Obama! Obama!
They ran there to speak to the president and ask him, please don't destroy the last place we have. Stop the black snake and start the healing of this continent. In the first days on the blockade, we asked for people to come to stand with us. It was a shout in the dark. If anybody would hear us, if anybody would care. A camp grew along the banks of the Missouri River. We called it Ocheti Shakoi, the Seven Council Fires. Thousands from all over the continent and the world came to pray with us, to face the fear with love. We call ourselves Water Protectors. We are here to protect the water. And the people that answered those calls were the strong hearts of their nation.
I did two tours in Iraq, 03 and 04.
I came back angry and guilty and for the things that we did over there. Once we got there, we realized this war is not about terrorists. This war is about oil. This war is about money. My vow today is to fight for clean water, to fight for a beautiful environment, because the beauty of the land will always show us that we need to take care of each other as well.
I was sitting in my apartment in Washington, D.C. I'm an attorney out there. And as an indigenous woman, as a keeper of the water, and also as someone that knows how much these projects disparately impact our communities, I got in my car and I came here. It really wasn't a choice. I had to be here. And I had to throw everything I possibly could to try and help stop this pipeline from happening.
What's going on here at Standing Rock isn't just about Standing Rock. It's not just about stopping a pipeline. It's not just about the Missouri River. Although there is 18 million people that get their water from the Missouri River, this is about the entire planet, the planet as a whole. This is about the survival of humanity. We're all here for the same reason, and I'll protect them with my life. They're my family.
This is where my story enters the dream. That's when I learned that at the base of the system is a person in a cage. As we're arrested, they put numbers on our arms. We were put in cages, like dog kennels.
The images are burned into my mind right now of these, the sounds of my people screaming in horror. Our young people shot off those horses with those rubber bullets. And it's something I can't escape from right now. We're not violent criminals, and we're not bad people. We're not murderers, and we're not rapists. We're not drug dealers, just everyday people that just want a better life for our children. I never understood what they said when they talked about people with PTSD and what they experience. And I understand it now, and I wouldn't wish that on anybody. I hear noises, and it brings me right back to that moment, but it never stops.
It was as if this ancient battle is playing itself out right before my eyes. They came to our sacred burial ground we call Turtle Island. They walked upon the burial sites of our ancestors. We pleaded with them to leave. The water protectors came, and they brought with them their beautiful spirits and their prayers. The youth council and friends who had come to protect the water had come to see and realize that we're not separate from spirit and from life. They stood in the water saying, "We're praying for you. These people are true warriors, these young people, our youth." They were in the water, and they didn't get cold. They were sprayed with pepper spray and mace. They didn't get angry. They cried tears of joy. They didn't hurl ugly insults as they were taunted. But they prayed for these people that were spraying them.
We're in the water. We're here to protect the water, so the water's going to protect us in turn. And I was in there for maybe an hour and a half, and I didn't get hypothermia. And that water's freezing.
How spirits on our side as we were up there on the front lines. One of the brothers, and I say brothers, you know, they are still our brothers and sisters. He fainted. He was on the front lines, and he fainted.
Wow.
There's prayer here, and we're strong prayer, and we're absolutely protected by spirit. They too are human beings, despite all of the armor they have on. They're tired.
Emotionally.
And look at us.
You know, we're
happy.
We defeat fear every day. A battle raged for several days. It's the same story of the Battle of Loa Bighorn, but it's today. The police continued to abuse their authority with violence, just like the 7th Cavalry. Reporters were shot in the middle of interviews.
Oh!
Who the fuck is that?
You got hit?
Josh.
Oh my God. Did he just shot you?
Because they stood with us, they were open targets.
What are we doing? Our land is under attack!
Stand up, fight back!
What are we doing? Our water is under attack!
Stand up, fight back!
What are we doing? Our people are under attack!
Stand up, fight back!
This is illegal. They're on treaty land right now. It is illegal for them to be there. And it is illegal for them to even lay their hands or even spray us with, you know, their weapons on our land. Our ancestors are buried on that mountain behind them. It is called Turtle Island. And our ancestors are up there.
When people come up here, we ask that they come here in prayer, not in violence. If you're going to be violent up here, we ask you to stay home. We're peaceful protectors.
Those are our synagogues, those are our Eiffel Towers, our pyramids, you know. You don't see, when you look out on the land, you don't see anything like that. Like how it comes up out of the ground. Everything about us was with the earth, and including our sights.
We have everything we need at camp. We chop wood, carry water, tend to the sick and injured. We create art. We report to the outside world. We cook for ourselves. There's no money. There's no electricity. There's no hate. There's no fear. There's no starvation. There's no homelessness. Above all else, we pray.
We won't stand for no more oil lies. Let the sacred water be life. Standing Rock, we stand with you tonight.
We lose track of days, not mandated by a clock or a calendar. We are here to serve. We face death on the front lines.
Many which only water is life.
We will not be violent. We will not fight back in that way. We will not feed into the negativity. We won't give that negativity life. We won't give it our life. We are something new on the planet, but we're not. We are something very old. We are warriors of peace. We won't surrender.
This is my weapon. I'm gonna kill him with candy and love and hugs.
Apple
workers.
Okay.
Tomorrow I'm gonna bring him a poster. I'm
here to protect the water and to connect back to my roots and remember who I truly am and what I'm here to accomplish. Because along the way, we've lost it by working and not having time to ourselves to get to know who we truly are and what we're here to do. What are they gonna do, shoot me? Okay, and then what? Take one for the team? Take one for the water and our people? Of course. They honestly believe that the pipeline's not gonna burst. They've made it okay for them to think that it's okay for it to happen and it's not as bad as it seems. So I want to show them that what we're doing isn't to hurt Dapple. We're not trying to hurt each other, because they said they're in between Dapple and us. So I just want them to feel. They could feel it.
We call Survivors Day, Thanksgiving, as Americans all sat down to their dinner table. We built a bridge, so that people could get across to Turtle Island to pray and show that we're still here.
We do not want a confrontation. The building of the bridge is an act of aggression to come over to this side. We cannot allow that to happen.
Had been brutalized, but the people weren't afraid. People were doing what their heart was telling them to do.
There does not need to be a confrontation today. Please go back across the river.
Today, as Americans may know, today is Thanksgiving. As Americans may not know, because of what we've been taught throughout our lives, is that Thanksgiving is actually a massacre. So for our Native American brothers and sisters to be here, to be in a protective stance, to say water is life, and to show no fear, unarmed, makes their ancestors proud, and it rewrites history. Today, we rewrite Thanksgiving. We take back thanks-taking, thanks-killing. We rewrite it as a peaceful, prayerful action that shows life.
Being a Native person, we're taught to be gracious hosts. We're taught to be inviting people to feed whoever's coming into our homes, to feed them and make them feel comfortable. And that's what happened. People came over and they were lost, scared, cold, and we warmed them, fed them, taught them the land and helped them. But it totally flipped, and that gracious host mentality was taken full advantage of.
And they make you react. React mode is a lower mode. Prayerful mode is the power, because you carry the truth.
Respect your right to assemble. On the other side of the river, on the clear side of the river, and you can protest all day.
We are mourning this day, which is why we're doing this. This is a day of mourning for us. Stay celebrated. We do not. Remember that. Stay prayerful. Stay peaceful.
Your ashes are a blessing.
If anyone doesn't have one.
I hate Thanksgiving so much. I struggle with Thanksgiving every single year.
It's the beginning of the genocide.
All I want is for my children to have a future, and nothing more, nothing less.
Drink water from the Missouri River. I told him the other day, what are you gonna say when you go home tonight and your son or your daughter wakes up in the middle of the night and says, Dad or Mom, can I have a drink of water? Are you going to tell them that you were there protecting that source of life for them? Or are you going to tell them that you had a gun pointed at my head for protecting that water for your children?
The day after Survivor's Day, the police put razor wire around our burial ground, Turtle Island, as if they owned it. It is us who belong to the land. We belong to the water. We belong to the air. We belong to all of creation. And it's not the other way around. I am from here. I'm born of the Ocheti Shakoi people. But I know that I'm a guest here. And we're all guests. We're all guests on Mother Earth. Unchi Makha. We're all guests in this dream. The Dakota Access Pipeline isn't the only snake there is. There's hundreds that are being proposed to drill across the United States, to put a pipeline in everyone's backyard. The horrifying vision of this country. This is just one of the battles that we all need to fight. Tatanka Iotake, Sitting Bull, was a prophet. One of the things that he said was that if a man loses something and goes back to look for it, he'll find it. He's speaking to us in this day in how to reclaim our identity and to heal. When you come to camp, you're greeted by security at the front gate, saying, "Welcome home." Our camp is a place to relearn values we've lost. And that's why it's home. I am not dreaming. I'm awake. I have been woken by the spirit inside that demanded I open my eyes and see the world around me. See that my children's future was in peril. See that my life couldn't wait in slumber anymore. See that I was honored to be among those who are awake. To be alive at this point in time. To see the rising of the Ocheti Shakoi. To see the gathering of nations. And beyond that, the gathering of all races and all faiths. Will you wake up and dream with us? Will you join our dream? Will you join us?